This one says 16th century English melody, or it'll say a Catalonian carol or something like that. But then the person who arranged it for Handbells, they get mentioned because they're fairly new. So anyway, so when you see that new program, that's the guy that arranged this. So if you like that, you can say, oh, I'll remember his name because when I see music like that again, it'll be like nice like that one. Okay, so what child is this? Like does make it sound like the bells got a little louder for a second. The other one is called an echo. And an echo is where you strike the bell and lightly tap it on the pad. And it makes this, because again, the bells take so much effort to stop them from vibrating, it actually makes this sound that sort of interrupts the ringing, but not completely. So you kind of get this. So my daughter dubbed them womp womps. So in this song, we have tower swings and womp womps. And now, I thought I'd tell you this. This is a joke. It's a bell joke. See Jason on the end there? He has tower swings, but look where he is. He's so close to the wall that if he hits it too fast, he'll have a Walmart.
Thank you.
Okay, well, ringlets. That was for the 5 or 6 year olds. Then there are the names for groups where they come from. One of the churches I was in was the Harris United Methodist Church. I bring this up because we decided to call one of our groups the Humringers, Hum Harris United Methodist Church, instead of the Humdingers, we were the Humringers. And the other group in that church was a little more somber, newer to the music, so they decided to call themselves the Spirit Movers. And that was a very nice name and kind of said where they were at. I also know a group that used to meet in this gal's basement. I don't know what her real name was, but the short name was L, so we called them L's Bells. Other fun names, and they can be just fun names. Somebody suggested that the version. The quartet should be called the Ding-a-lings. And why not just a gal's name, I guess. And then there was the group of women that used to come to these conferences that we would have. And there was one woman in there who was about probably my age now. I mean, she was then. She was about 45, 50 years old. And the rest of them were all over 70. And they called themselves the Ding Dong Dollies. So you see, a name can be anything. It can have any bell part or church part or feeling part to it. So anyway, if you have a suggestion, if you think of something, I want you to fill it out on your little ticket. You can use more tickets if you get inspired more than once from the music you play or what we talk about in the bells. We are going to have a winner, or we will choose a name, and when we do, we will announce it the first part of probably sometime in February, the first time we bring in service in 2014. And the prize will be you to hear your name mentioned forever be known as the person who named the bell choir. And again, at the end of the concert, if you still have a suggestion, there's a basket out on it's on the left-hand side basket. It's got a little tag on it. And so now, I'd like to introduce the vocal choir, directed by Zenora Swanson, who are going to correct right there. You have to be a director. And the name of the piece is He Came. All don't need a name for the bell choir, but if it's on there, don't worry, we're going to lose it, we're going to save all those and look at them later. But you will be in the drawing, but make sure your name is on the bottom. We're going to be doing that in a few minutes. Actually, after the next song. I mean, we're going to play our fourth piece. So, the next, because I switched the order, the next piece is Handbell Ensembles.
surprise. So let's see. A young guy over there.
Thank you.
Okay, now we have our second drawing. Our second drawing.
Second drawing.
And if the bell choir needs to go up and get their next piece ready.
Jackie.
Karen.